So I walked into a newsagent and took some photographs of the newspaper covers for this video. I chose the particular newsagent because of the wide variety of Australian and international newspapers. I will add some additional imagery to illustrate the concepts in this video also. To start off with, I live in Sydney. The Sydney Morning Herald newspaper is obviously local and is largely regarded as Sydney's own and most respectable newspaper. But what is the Sydney Morning Herald? I asked three people if they knew.
I'm just wondering what you think this means, Sydney Morning Herald. What does that mean?
To me, it's a daily newspaper.
Yeah. Does the actual wording have any meaning?
I honestly haven't thought about it.
So,
I hear the phrase, I think, of newspapers.
Yep.
You know, yep. And broadsheet, so yeah, you know. So yeah.
What does Sydney Morning Herald mean? Do you know what it means?
No.
Not really.
No.
Morning news.
Morning
daily
news.
Daily news.
Yeah.
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 Morning Herald.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a job page as well, isn't it? Like, it's well known for the jobs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The response was as I expected, so let's move on. Within the descriptives for Herald on the Merriam-Webster website, we can read definition of Herald, starting at 2. An official crier or messenger, 3a. One that precedes or foreshadows, 3b. One that conveys news or proclaims, 3c. One who actively promotes or advocates. Examples of herald in use. The early flowers are heralds of spring. Mercury was the herald of the Roman gods. Both Mercury and Venus are positioned between the Earth and the Sun. Apparently, both Mercury and Venus can be referred to as the morning star, due to them shining brightly just before sunrise in the morning. Let's focus on Mercury, as Mercury is known as the messenger god. I postulate that Mercury assumes this role in part due to its close proximity to the Sun, Mercury as an intermediary between Earth and the Sun, perhaps. Mercury is also the god of commerce and merchants. Followers of my video will recall that I found $12 on the statue of Mercury in the Vice Chancellor's Garden at Sydney University. Here we see Mercury with a cockerel at his feet. So, the Morning Herald is Mercury, the herald of the sun. Thus, we have papers titled Herald Sun, or Sun Herald. The sun also illuminates us with information, for without the sun we could not see, especially during a sun run, of course. Articles perhaps alluding to sun worship may be found within various newspapers. Now imagine if the Sydney Morning Herald was titled the Catholic Herald, or better still, the Sydney Morning Jesus. Would your perception of this newspaper content change? Some newspapers are simply titled Mercury. In Sydney, there are bicycle couriers reminding us of that wheel between Mercury's legs. Mercury also points to his pineal gland, reminding one of telepathy, perhaps, and telegraphs. Telegraphy is the long-distance transmission of messages using some form of on-off coding system. Melbourne's newspaper, The Age, sports the lion and unicorn. The unicorn is associated with Capricorn, whilst the lion represents Leo. These are both houses of the zodiac. We are currently in the age of Pisces. The Canberra Times perhaps relates to Father Time, the most prominent deity I could find in Australia's Parliament House in Canberra. Father Time, or Kronos, is the Saturnian god. The black cube, and thus black square, are possibly related to Saturn. It is no coincidence, in my opinion, that Times Square in New York is called Times Square. Both are perhaps a reference to Saturnian worship. With the hourglass and sickle, Kronos is the Grim Reaper in part. People in New York celebrated the death of Osama bin Laden in Times Square. By the way, Time magazine was founded by Britton Haddon and Henry Robinson Luce. Both were members of Skull and Bones. Skull and Bones reminds me of death. Notice the clock in this picture behind the bonesman. I think we can be reasonably confident that Times relates to Saturnian worship in these cases. Anyway, so basically, newspapers are perhaps selling your subconscious mind information from the cosmos, just like a university. Although, in my opinion, this is far from the truth. Now is an apt time to point out that graduates receiving their degrees and master's degrees within the Great Hall of Sydney University do so with a black square above on their heads and a black square below on the floor. If we join the lines up, the student is perhaps symbolically in a box. On drawing this concept illustration, I found myself reminded somewhat of the Saturnian god Kronos' hourglass. Could this bring new meaning to the hourglass figure? Who knows? Here is Australia's Governor General performing a ceremony on Australia's 9/11. Within the Great Hall of Sydney University. The tripod arrangement is unmistakably Masonic, and upon the chequered floor no less. Now, Australia's Governor-General Quentin Bryce breaks the wine bottle, the phallic wine bottle, and the white froth shoots forth. You can see the wine bottle in the hand of the horny god Pan. The white froth shoots forth onto the Vesica Pisces-like vessel. You can see the vessel symbolically placed at the feet of Pan's maiden. The vessel, named Quentin Bryce, is now ready for its maiden voyage. The Governor General of the Commonwealth of Australia is the representative in Australia of the British monarch, currently Queen Elizabeth II, as seen here within the Masonic Library, Goulburn Street, Sydney. Let's get back to the newspaper theme. The Guardian newspaper refers to the Guardian Angel, as seen on the Trinidad Guardian. Who is that guardian angel? On this logo, we see an angel silhouetted against the sun. Perhaps both the angel and the sun are light bringers. The Australian newspaper is just that. So I'll keep this brief. The etymology of Australia is derived from the Latin australis, meaning southern. On the Australian flag, you can find the Southern Cross. On the Australian flag, you can also find what is perhaps the blazing star, the Commonwealth Star. The blazing star is located in the east on a Masonic tracing board. Australia is located below Southeast Asia, in the southeast portion of a common world map. Pause the video if you want to read the related etymology regarding Latin and perhaps German roots regarding the word or the name Australia. I've noticed that commonly the land masses on the newspapers are printed in red, which perhaps relates to red, the red fire triangle, the fire sign, the fire element. The financial review I took a photo of happened to have the crimson thread of kinship running through the title. We can see this thread before the Federation Pavilion and on the Mercure Hotel. Of course, Mercure relates to Mercury, the messenger god, and commerce, as per the financial review. The crimson thread of kinship perhaps relates to either bloodlines or connectedness across the cosmos. Anyway, I hope you have enjoyed the presentation. I know of and have known people who work within the media. I've lost contact with the guy who left the Sydney Morning Herald as a photographer because he didn't like the way they used his photographs. He didn't like the context in which they used his photographs. I also know someone who writes articles for Reuters and marvels that she can put a bit of spin on certain stories. This particular person is in favour of the official version of global warming and enjoys giving supporters support within her articles. Now, if this person or any other person working within these newspapers was to try and cover the non-official version of the September 11, 2001 attacks in America, this would certainly be a different case. The big picture I'm trying to paint here is much larger than all of that, and encroaches on the topic of mind control and mass mind control, something I consider that I'm personally prone to. Anyway, it's a big subject. As I've said before, I've turned down interviews before from the Sydney Morning Herald. A reporter wanted to interview me on something unrelated to the work I'm doing here on the occult. I also turned down a reporter from the ABC television network who wanted to interview me on something. Once again, it wasn't related to the work I'm doing here on the occult. But I don't want to speak to these organisations. Basically, I reject them. To a certain degree, that they have their place, but for the most part, I reject them. I don't take them seriously. And I'll just leave it at that. That's my personal opinion. So, all the best. Bye for now.
Australia's first public smart charge station installed by Vision Stream.